Okay, so today we are doing the practical with the help of a video. So the aim of the practical is identification of parenchymas, colenchymas, sclerenchyma tissue in plant and stripped smooth and cardiac muscle fibers and nerve fibers in animals from a permanent slides and draw well labeled diagram. And you can't, we're not coming to school and this is our online class. So we will see a video regarding this and this will help you. That the student will come and I will be sharing the videos. Okay. The permanent slides are available in the lab itself. And from the permanent slide, you have to identify the tissue and then you have to make the diagram. Okay, what kind of tissue? Okay, so moving side right down. So the practical is identification of the parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma tissue in plant. We have done three type of these. If you remember, these are three permanent tissues: parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma. And the sclerenchyma is the dead one. And the colenchyma has a thickening at the corners. Sclerenchyma has the lignin. But you have to do is the in the practical itself lab, the manual lab, you have to do in that. You have two practicals. Already we have done plants and animal cell in the first term. And this is the, for the second term you are having. Yes, you have to write. You have to write like this, the procedure. Then what is the aim, what is the material required. When I will be sharing the video, you will know how to write. This is an experiment, the second experiment you are having the syllabus. You have to write in the activity file, bete. You have to write. Okay. So I'm waiting for one more minute and then I will be sharing, just write down the activity. This is a practical. Now you are having only two practicals in the syllabus from the bio portion. One we have already done. And second one, I was thinking we can do in the lab, but these are the permanent slide. You can't see as such. So I am sharing the video, which will help you. So let the student will come and then I will be sharing the video. Okay. So already the 5 minutes are given to you and let me know the voice is audible to you or not.
Plant and animal tissues. Parenchyma tissue. Materials required: prepared slide of parenchyma tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure: place the prepared slide of parenchyma tissue on the stage of the compound microscope. Observe the features of the parenchyma tissue through the lens of the compound microscope. Observations: all cells are isodiametric in shape, which means the...
Observation. What are the observations we have already done regarding this tissue? So you should know what are the type of the parenchymatic cells are these. You will tell me. And write in the chat box or raise your hand, I will unmute you. What are the characteristics of this parenchyma cell? Then I'll show you the observation. And raise your hands, bete. You want to answer. We have done three types of permanent tissue, simple permanent tissue, that is parenchyma, sclerenchyma, and colenchyma. So who is writing? You have listened, that is isodiametric. Yes, it is right. More intercellular space is right. Okay. So now let us see what are the observation. See, where are these parenchyma are present? You have done the structure of secondary dicot stem. Where are these present? Okay, this man is large central vacuole, is right, there's nucleus, someone is writing thin cell walls, it doesn't have any kind of thickening, the cell walls are thin. Okay, where they are present? Can you tell me where they are present? You've already done. You are writing the features, yes, cytoplasm, where they are present, bete? In the plant, where they are present, what is the function of the parenchyma? Jab parenchyma aayega, I have told you what should strike in your mind. Mesophyll of the cell, leaves, okay. What is the function? Can anyone tell? You can raise the hand. Store food, very good. So let us see what are its observation. Very good.
Observations. All cells are isodiametric in shape, which means the cells have the same length and width. The cells in the tissue are loosely packed with large intercellular spaces between each cell. The cells contain cytoplasm and a nucleus and are surrounded by a cell wall. Each cell has a vacuole in the center. Inference. As the cells have a thin cell wall, are isodiametric in shape and have a large vacuole that is present in the cytoplasm, we can confirm that the tissue seen on the slide is a parenchyma tissue. Sclerenchyma. Material.
Anji, theek. So parenchymatic tissue are isodiametric and they have the thin cell wall. And they do have large vacuole, we have seen. They help in the storage of food. They are present in the epidermis, hai na? So you should know the locations. Okay? All the things. Hanji. You can raise the hand, bete. Ma'am, nucleus to bar level. Yeah, they have done in the slide. They have done in the different cells. So now let us see what all about sclerenchyma.
Materials required. Prepared slide of sclerenchyma tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure. Place the prepared slide of the sclerenchyma tissue on the stage of the compound microscope. Observe the features of the sclerenchyma tissue through the lens of the compound microscope. Observations.
Now what will be the
sclerenchyma tissue?
You can tell me what will be the observation in the case of sclerenchyma. Hanji, anyone bete? You can write in the chat box or raise your hands. What are the observation do you think? The students are writing. Less intercellular spaces, no intercellular spaces, very good. Thick wall, why their walls are thick? Because of presence of lignin, very good, Nishtha. Hanji, so in xylem and phloem, is there sclerenchyma is present? No, in xylem and phloem, no sclerenchyma is there. What are phloem fibers and xylem fibers are made up of? Where they are present? Sclerenchyma, what is the function of lignin? So many of you are writing, they are thick walled, they have no intercellular spaces, they have deposition of lignin. Now my next question is, where this sclerenchyma is present? If you are asked with which tissue is present in the husk of coconut, what will you be giving the answer? Husk of coconut, mein kaun sa tissue? what answer you will give? Sclerenchyma. Achha, xylem fibers are made up of sclerenchyma. Now, phloem fibers are made up of sclerenchyma. So, what is the function of sclerenchyma? Can anyone tell me what is the function of it is sclerenchyma? Oops, guys, entering. Protection, somebody is writing. Strength, yes. Mechanical support, yes, you're right. They're hard and stiff, right? So let us see the observation now.
Tissue consists of thick-walled dead cells. These cells are long, narrow, and have hard and extremely thick secondary walls due to uniform distribution of lignin. There are no intercellular spaces between the cells in the sclerenchyma tissue. The cell contains little or no protoplasm. Nucleus is absent in the cell. The cell contains empty vacuoles that are called lumen. Inference. As the cells have thickened cell walls and little protoplasm, we can confirm that the tissue seen on the slide is a sclerenchyma tissue. Striated muscle.
Hanji, straighted muscles. What kind of muscles are these? We have done three types of muscles, striated, unstriated and cardiac. What are the difference between them? And anyone can tell me? Which one is voluntary, which is involuntary? Cardiac is too present in the heart from the striatus. Yes, very good. Striated consists of dark and light bands. Very good. You're writing right one. So this observation we will be having. Or anyone or points bolna chahe? They're voluntary or involuntary? They are under our control or not under our control? So Nishtha is writing involuntary. Simon is writing voluntary. Prince is writing voluntary. What do you mean by voluntary? Now Tani is writing involuntary. What do you mean by voluntary and involuntary? You're not clear with that only. Jasleen is writing voluntary. Under our control. These are under our control. So let us see the observation. Maybe it is clear to you.
Materials required. Prepared slide of straighted muscle tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure. Place the prepared slide of straighted muscle tissue on the stage of the compound microscope. Observe the features of the straighted muscle tissues through the lens of the compound microscope. Observations. The straighted muscle cells are very long and have cylindrical fibers. The fibers are enclosed within a membrane called sarcolemma. These fibers are nucleated, which means they have many nuclei. Each cell cytoplasm consists of many myofibrils. Each myofibril contains alternate light and dark bands, giving a striated appearance to the fibers. Inference. The presence of long cylindrical fibers that are multinucleated and the presence of many myofibrils confirms that the cells seen on the slide are striated muscle cells. Nervous tissues. Materials required. Prepared slide of nerve tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure. Place the prepared slide of the nerve tissue on the stage of the compound microscope. Observe the features of the nerve tissues through the lens of the compound microscope. Observations. the large body of the neuron is called the soma, which contains the cell's nucleus. The cell body branches out to form the dendrites. These dendrites further branch out to form fibers of different lines called dendrites. There is also a single long fiber projecting from the cell body called the axon. The axon is covered by the myelin sheath. In friends, the presence of cells with a large cell body, one prominent nucleus, dendrites and a large axon confirms that tissue seen on the slide is nerve tissue.
Now, who will tell me what is the difference between striated and unstriated? Hurry up. Striated, you are not cleared which are under our control and which are not under our control. Prince, you haven't written anything, Hanji. Both are striated, you are good. And which are voluntary and which are non-voluntary, which are under our control and which are not under our control? Who will tell me, bete? So, bete, striated, basically, are voluntary and unstriated are involuntary in nature. Theek? Okay? So, the striated are also known as skeletal and unstriated are also known as smooth. Theek? Okay? Getting the point? Anji, anyone? If you have any doubt, you can ask. Non-striated, basically, which are involuntary, which are not under our control, they are present in the bladder, blood vessels, bronchi, and all the stuff. See? And the striated one are like the attached bone and tendon, their main function in the movement and the locomotion. See? So their voluntary muscles means they are under our control. The striated one are under our control and no striated one are not under our control with it. That is unstriated are not under our control. See? Okay, bete. Any other doubt? So, cardiac. Who will tell me the cardiac? Who will tell me the cardiac? Hurry up. No one? Any doubt, bete? All doubts are cleared. Tanya is writing. So we have done with it three type of permanent tissue. That is simple permanent parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. Like we have seen in this particular slide, sclerenchyma and likewise there are collenchyma slides also. In that there will be this thickening at the corner will be there. Theek? And in case of, if you're comparing striated, unstriated, and cardiac, striated are under our control. They are actually helpful in the movement. And unstriated, which are not consisting of any striation, it is present in our bronchi and inner vessels like blood vessels and all. So they are not under our control and such, and they don't have any kind of light and dark bands. Okay, Next, we have done cardiac. It is present in the heart, and it is again not in under our control, and it doesn't get fatigue also. Like unstriated, it also doesn't get fatigue. So regarding now nerve cells we have already done. It has a cytone body. Then there is nerve ending, there is axon, there are dendrites, theek, which help to pass the message from one like sense organs to brain or spinal cord and vice versa. Okay, ha, it have myelin sheath, you're right. So this was a practical remaining with us. Now do your practical. And which chapter do you want for the revision tomorrow? Why do we fall ill? Or the tissue, the last one we have done. And on Friday, you will be having the test of why do we fall ill. Okay. So why do we fall ill? The two tissue are coming to me. Tissue, so many tissues. You know, Friday, you will be having with a test. Remember, on Friday, you will be having the test on why do we fall ill. Most of we have covered why do we fall ill. And we are remaining with 4 days now. After tomorrow, we are having the 4 days. And there are 3 chapters to go. What is the difference between immunization and vaccine? In the immunization is a broader term, and vaccination is the term, sub-term we can say, in the immunization. Means immunization is to build the immunity. So immunity can be built by vaccination. Okay, Tania. Immunization means to build an immunity by the different process, the different procedure. From the different, from the different procedure, the one of the procedure which we are doing is the vaccination. And they don't require any energy. Vaccination means you are providing the weaker microorganisms and all. They are partially dead or weakened. You are providing, you are injecting in the body, and your body synthesize antibodies to confront that antigens in the body. So in the vaccination, you provide weakened or partially killed microorganisms. So to build the body immune system. So immunization and vaccination is we can say a term which has a equivalent to each other, but immunization is a broader term and vaccination is a sub term we can say in the immunization. Immunization word means to build up the immunity, and this immunity can be built by vaccination. So all the chapter, all three you have done. That is why do we fall ill. Tissue and cell is coming on the exam. Cell has less weightage as compared to the two chapters. This one, what do you want to say? No immunization, write down fully. The vaccination is the process of injecting a killed micro, partially killed microorganism or a weakened microorganism. No, but basically NCRT and what you have done in the class, that will only come. Pehle NCRT padh lo, and jo bhi aapko assignments and all mili hai, that you have done, you have to do, and what we have done in the class. Okay, you will find other video which consists of colon chyme and all. I will send that video also. Why do we fall? Wala part revise karwa dena kal. Okay, we will do why do we fall in tomorrow, and then we will be remaining with 4 chapters to go with it. The 4 days to go, and we will do the rest of the chapters. Okay? Hanji. After vaccine, yes, definitely it is. वैक्सीन से चांस बहुत कम हो जाते हैं. वैक्सीन से अगर यू हैव गिवन द वैक्सीनेशन देन द चांसेस आर लेस. कब ये नहीं हो सकता कि डिजीज हो ही नहीं सकती अगर इफ वन टाइम यू आर वैक्सीनेटेड. कभी कभी हमें बूस्टर्स देने पड़ते हैं. यू आर नॉट टेकिंग द बूस्टर्स फॉर दैट. हो सकता है कि दोबारा हो जाए. तो इफ यू रीड द चार्ट यू विल सी देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ बूस्टर्स अवेलेबल. लाइक इन द व्हेन यू आर इन द चाइल्डहुड यू आर गिवन द वैक्सीन अगेंस्ट टेटनस. बट इट डजंट मींस यू हैव यू नीड डजंट नीड एनी इंजेक्शन ऑफ द टेटनस. Whenever कोई भी रोड पे आपको इंजरी हो जाती है तो मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आपने घर पे सुना होगा इसको टेटनस का इंजेक्शन लगा दो. बूस्टर मीन्स दोबारा से हम एंटीबॉडीज डालते हैं. थोड़ी सी दोबारा से वीकन डाला जाता है क्योंकि आपकी बॉडी इतनी पुरानी बात भूल ना जाए. पोलियो की जो ड्रॉप्स हमने ये भी देखा कि एक बार बच्चे को दी जाती है तो नेक्स्ट ईयर दोबारा भी दी जा सकती है. To boost the immunity. The boosters are for the boost the immunity. It is see on a Friday you are having test of why do we fall in. So we will practicing more question about why do we fall in. And the video, if I am getting the video, this colon chyma is remaining in the video. I'll show you that also. Okay. And start sending your notebook. Start sending you the notebook, okay? Okay, bete.